With the ascension of Vice President Lyndon Johnson, there would be important changes in many of Kennedy's policies, particularly towards the Soviet Union and Vietnam.
I will do my best. That is all I can do.
In his inaugural address in the morning of that decade in January 1961,
let the word go forth from this time and place to friend and foe alike, that the torch has been passed to a new generation of Americans.
But with his murder, the torch was passed back to an old generation, the generation of Johnson, Nixon, Ford, and Reagan, leaders who would systematically destroy the promise of Kennedy's last year as they returned the country to war and repression. Though the vision Khrushchev and Kennedy had expressed would fall with them, they would not die. The seeds they had planted would germinate and sprout again long after their deaths. For those of us who lived through the 1960s, the Cuban Missile Crisis, coming on the heels of the war scare over Berlin, was a terrifying event. It was one of many nightmares, call it punches to the stomach of a new generation of American people who had never seen history unfold so quickly, so dramatically, and in such a violent fashion. It would soon be followed by the invasion of Vietnam, a bloodbath, a nightmare of America's own making that would eat Vietnamese and Americans alive for almost a decade. More horrifying things were to come by the end of that decade. But in hindsight, it was on that afternoon in Dallas, when John Kennedy's head was blown off in broad daylight. It was as if a giant, horrific Greek Medusa had unearthed its hideous face to the American people, freezing us with an oracle of things yet to come.